So here we're going to discuss what you should do with the inside arm in a sweep bait. Should it be locked out? Should it be straight and hard? Or should it be flexible and bent? Should it be bent a lot? The critical thing really is that it should be relaxed, and it should be has to be bent a little, so it can't be locked out. If it's locked out, then it's going to really distort the body in relation to the oar, because the oar's on an angle. It's also very important to make sure that the elbow is always above the handle. If the elbow drops down below the handle like that, then we've got particular issues. So let's have Lachlan demonstrate it and discuss what he's doing at the same time.
So at the catch, the inside arm should have a little bend in it. You don't want to be bent like this. You don't want to be down. You don't want to be too far up. And likewise, you don't want to be locked out. You hear a lot of people talk about locking the arm out at the catch, the inside arm. While you can do that, it really pops a joint into an uncomfortable position and makes it a lot harder for when you get started. So you have a straight arm, but it's straight-ish. It's just not locked out. So that's straight and that's straight. But you want to have it so it's not locked out, just a little bit of bend in it. And so, because you're moving straight up and down the middle of the boat anyway, you don't have to worry too much about it. If you have it straight, you're going to have to pivot the shoulders around. It's not going to be very comfortable. So it's just about getting into that catch position, slight bend in the arm, whatever's comfortable. And, you know, wherever your hand grip is, there or there, doesn't matter too much. Just having that nice little bend in the arm, nice and relaxed, not below the oar, not too far above it. And just ready to take the stroke.
And when you take the stroke from that position, then you have your inside leg vertical, and the essential power starts to be applied with the inside leg in that first position. And so it's the inside leg, then the outside arm. And that's essentially how the drive phase works. Yes, the rest of the muscles play their part, of course, but it's important to be really relaxed. If you're not relaxed in that position there and have that correct inside arm relaxed and slightly bent, then you'll find that it's really difficult to get that position. And if you're relaxed, you've got a much better chance of placing the blade well. If you've got a locked out arm, it's really difficult to place the blade well. So make sure you're relaxed at all times and keep that inside elbow under control.